The name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Well, today we offer the Mass in honor of St. Boniface. He was born around the year 680, and he died as a martyr in the year 754. Well, one of the ways for businessmen to sell what they have is to distribute samples to people. I don't know if you have seen people distributing samples of their food or perfumes or things like that. Well, that's a very good way of being successful in business. Now the question is, what would happen, or what would you think of a sample being of an inferior quality to what it represents? People wouldn't buy any of those things. See? Now, all popular movements or institutions are judged more or less by their members and representatives, and the same holds true when it comes to religion. Every Catholic becomes, for his own friends and relatives, a sample by which others judge the faith which he professes, as a cause is judged by its effects. And so we must somehow or another express in our lives something at least of the beauty of God, the beauty of the Church, and whatever is characteristic of our Catholic faith. So the question is, how do I represent the Church? See? And this is an important question which we must ask ourselves. So is our life a fair sample by which men can rightly judge the beauty of God, the goodness of God, the omnipotence of God? How effective is our testimony for other people to see? How much influence we have on other people? Because we know that Catholics sometimes present in their lives a contradiction of the sublime teachings of the faith. So they become like lying samples by which men falsely judge the truth of the Church, the purity of her doctrine. So they become like obstacles that impede the progress of the gospel. Now, we also have Catholics who have become indifferent to their religion. So they are deceptive samples of the faith. We also have Catholics who have become lukewarm, and they feel they have a difficult time manifesting in themselves the truth of the Church, the doctrine of the Church. So they don't weigh in the scale. They do not dare to represent the Church and the principles for which it stands. But finally, there are those who, to a greater or less extent, truly and worthily represent in their words and actions and in all their lives, the church of which they are members. So they are the real examples in whom men may see something at least of the truth and beauty of the one and only Catholic Church that Christ established. Their lives are the best, are the test by which many may be engaged in some measure the beauty of the Church. So knowing that we have as a vocation to bring other people closer to Christ, we need to keep to take into consideration the value, the power of our influence that we exercise over other people. St. Paul used to tell people this thing. He said, "Be imitators of me, as I am also an imitator of Christ." And that's what we should be able to tell everybody else. See? So that is why giving good example with our words, with our actions, is a very important thing, part of our vocation. And Jesus tells us in the Gospel, "You are the light of the world. A city seated on a mountain cannot be hidden." See, he says, "Neither do men light a candle and put it under a table, but upon a candlestick, that it may shine to all those who are in the house." So let your light shine before men, that they may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.